Welcome to a brand new day with Praise Tabernacle Church. Now join us for a service already in progress. God bless you, and remember, Jesus died for you.
so stronger than we need, rising from the African plain. It's the song of the forgiven, drowning out the Amazon rain. It's the song of the believers, filled with God's holy fire. It's every tribe, every tongue, every nation in God's holy choir.
Thank you, Lord.
All God's children singing glory, glory.
When Jesus comes,
black moment. When the clock tore out the highway, we'll mount to a home on God's celestial shore.
Amen. Gonna say I've been to church. Let me tell you something. I remember meetings where everybody in the house was running. I remember meetings where it was pouring down rain outside one day, and a preacher took off around the place, and he come back in and didn't have no mud on his feet. He was that high off the ground when he run around that church. That's the power of the Holy Ghost. If you'll only say, Jesus, use me, praise God. He's been in this place. He's stirring up his church in these last days. We have to stir up the gifts, glory to God. Stirring up the gifts is what the Holy Ghost is doing right now. He's trying to get us excited about Jesus again. He's trying to get us on fire about Jesus again. He's raising up a remnant that will not bow to this world, but will worship Him through thick and thin. We'll worship Him when the devil says don't worship Him. We'll worship Him when the worst things get worse, glory to God. Jesus is alive and well and on the throne, and we ought to love Him this morning. Hallelujah. Woo! I'm going to get fired up in a minute.
Amen.
I'm going to read you something from Deuteronomy. You don't have to go there, but I'm going to get you to go to one more verse in just a moment. Just a moment. The book says, little Bobby, in Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 18, but thou shalt remember the Lord thy God. He's talking to all the nations. For it is He that giveth thee power to get wealth, that He may establish His covenant, which He sware unto thy fathers, and it is this day. And it shall be, if thou do at all forget the Lord thy God, and walk after another God, and serve them and worship them, I testify against you this day that ye shall surely perish.
Amen.
He's talking to the nations. He's talking about worshiping other gods. He's talking about abomination unto God. He's talking about man trying to run the show, in layman's term. Man trying to not remember where they came from. Let me tell you something about America, if I could. America's in rough shape this morning. America, if you hadn't looked around and began to look at your country and where it's headed, it's in rough shape this morning. America, founded on God's Word, dedicated to His will and concentrated to His purposes from its very inception. America, those who came to these shores 4 centuries ago to found a new civilization, did so by dedicating it to God. We're talking about Jesus, folks. We're not talking about Allah or Buddha. Committing it for His purposes and His glory. America was to be a city on a hill, a civilization to which others would look. It was to be a holy commonwealth, and so they modeled it after Israel of the Bible. They brought forth its first governments in the name of Jesus, listen to that, and for the glory of God. They established its first school system for the purpose of teaching the Word of God. And they foretold that inasmuch as America would follow in the ways of God, that God would bless it. That it would become the most powerful, the most prosperous, the most blessed nation on the face of the earth. And it would all come true. Everything that our forefathers spoke of. When this nation, I don't know how many of you knew what you were celebrating last night, but in 1776, America won the Revolutionary War. You see, England was trying to take over the 13 colonies that we have had established in America. England, the King of England said, we want it for our territory. But some brave men and women rose up and said, this is America. We stand for God. And they rose up, people like Paul Revere, people like John Adams, people like Sam Adams and Benjamin Franklin, rose up and said, we'll fight against this revolution. This is America. And they fought against it. And in 1776, we received our independence. It's why we celebrate the 4th of July. It's nothing else but independence and freedom. From another country trying to put this country in bondage and tell us which God that we will serve. I don't know if you know this or not, but England, the majority of England, is Islamic religion now. I'm glad that America, the majority still yet, is Christianity or so-called Christianity. At least they're trying to be a Christian. Amen? But the true Christian, the true foundation of this nation, when they wrote the Declaration of Independence, when men of old sit down, godly men that believed in Jesus and put the words God in our Constitution and in our Declaration of Independence, it's a thing that stood for years and it worked because it guaranteed freedom and liberty and justice for all. To worship the God that we so choose. But there was only one God when they penned the Declaration. Now we have allowed men and women to break the Declaration and the Constitution over and over. And they took a poll the other day, the millennial generation. The millennial generation, that's my son's generation. That's your generation, Miss Katie. They said 55% of them wanted to leave this country. 55% of them. But now is the time. Now, it didn't even come out of my mouth when they passed a gay marriage law. Listen, when you pass that, you're messing with God's law. I don't care who you are or what you are or where you're from. Marriage was constitution by God Almighty between one man and one woman. And they've opened up a can of worms now where they're shaking their fist in the face of God and saying, I dare you to bring judgment. Well, America, judgment is coming. Judgment is coming. Preachers have been preaching this for years. That it was just going to fall into place and get worse and worse and worse and worse. And that's exactly what's happening. Persecution is coming to the church. This agenda that they have passed is one agenda only. It's not because they love each other and they want to be married. They want to bring down the traditional church. They want all of us pastors to bow to them, even if it takes taking our 501c3 away, which is a tax exempt where the church does not have to pay taxes. So they want to take that away. They also want to force pastors to marry them. Force pastors to marry the same-sex people. Let me tell you something. As long as this church doors are open, this old boy will never marry two gay people, whether it be two males or two females. Or they're already marrying their dogs in California. So how much more lower can we get, children? How much more lower can we stoop before all the morals and all the values are just swept out the door and no longer we care? What is this world going to do without the church? What are they going to do without Jesus? What are they going to do without on fire, Holy Ghost filled preachers that's standing up and saying, you better turn from that stuff. It's a sin. The Word says it is. And if you want to get into the gates of heaven, you better turn from it.